Hey guys, this is Martin again from Tours Electronics, and today I'm going to talk about how to control DMX lighting via an iPad or an iPhone. We're going to be using the Luminaire app. You can find it in the App Store, and that app is very popular because a lot of people enjoy that app because it's so easy and versatile to use. So you could create settings, presets, scenes, a bunch of cool stuff that you could customize to your liking. There are three key components that you will need for this setup. That would be a Wi-Fi router, ArtNet to DMX interface, and also an iPad. We're going to start off showing you how to set up the LM3R physically, how to connect the Ethernet cable and some switches, how the proper setting there should be at, and this is the way you start off. So basically, you'll see on your LM3R that there are two switches here on the bottom, and they have little arrows on them. Make sure both arrows are pointing at the zero. Okay. Next thing you want to do is connect your power supply. In this case, I already have it connected, but just make sure it's connected to the wall, and you can plug it in here. And if that light goes on, it means that it's working. You're getting power. Next thing you want to do is get an RJ45 network cable. And one end, you want to connect it to your LM3R. Okay. And the other end, you will connect that to your computer. Okay, once you've done that, that's pretty much all you do physically to the LM3R. So here's the screenshot video of how to do the network settings in the LM3R. Okay, so once you've already followed the previous instructions on how to connect your ArtNet cable, and you've set your subnet and universe settings to the proper settings I had just showed you. The next thing you want to do is actually configure your LM3 so that you can put it within the same range of your IP address router. So what you want to do is once you've downloaded the OSCillation application, which is there in the manual of the LM3R, you want to open that program up, and then you go where it says View, and you go to Devices, and you'll see there your LM3 MK2. Okay, you select that, and if you scroll down, you'll see IP1. That's your IP address, okay, of the LM3. That's the current IP address it's on. So make a note of that. Okay, write all of that down somewhere, and then just want to close all this stuff. Then you go to your control panel. Then you go where it says View Network Status and Tasks. Click on that. Then you click here where it says Local Area Connection. Okay, that's going to be your LM3. You go to Properties. Then you go to the Internet Protocol version 4. You double click on that. And generally, your computer is going to be like this. Okay, so then what you want to do is go to the use the following IP address. You select that. And you want to input the IP address that your LM3 R is on, but the last number, like for example here we had 2.1.10.89, your last number you want it to be a digit above. Okay, so we're gonna set it to 90, and if you just click here in the subnet mask, it'll actually input your subnet automatically. So just click okay, close, and close all of this. Now you open up an internet browser, and it shouldn't be connected to the internet or anything, your computer at this point. So it's probably going to try to load it, and it's not going to do anything. Here on top of the browser, you're going to input the IP address of your LM3R. I already have mine here, so you just input it exactly as it shows. You click go, like if you're going to, you know, on a regular website. And that's going to take you to the home of the configuration utility of the LM3R. Now, what you want to do is the following, and this is the most crucial step in getting this to actually work. You're going to want to change the IP address of your LM3R, which is here, to that of the same of your IP router. Okay. Usually routers have a sticker on the bottom that shows you their IP address, and it doesn't have to be the exact same IP address. It could be within the same range, but just to make it simple, we're going to set it at the same IP address as a router. So my router is 192.168.1.1. Okay. And if you actually go into your IP address settings prior to doing this, it'll also show you the subnet. In my case, it's a subnet of 255.255.0. Make sure when you're doing this that your router is turned off and not connected to your computer, because if you do this while it is connected to your computer, you're going to have an IP address conflict and it's going to cause some funny things. So usually when you're setting up Luminaire with your LM3R, you don't want to use the same router you're using for your internet. Usually it's better just to set it up separately. I mean, you could do it the other way, but this way it's just a little bit easier. So you just click, once you've done that, you click Save Settings. It's going to ask you if you really want to do it. You click OK again. And then you click OK here once again. And it's going to try to load you back to the previous IP address. But since it's been changed, it's not going to work. So it's just going to be spinning there. So you could just close your browser. Now, what you want to do is go back to your OSCillation 512 program, open that up, and we're going to go to View, we're going to go to Devices, you're going to select your device, and this is just for testing purposes, and we're going to make sure it actually changed it. So if you look here, it actually did change it to the 192.168.1.1, which is what we want, okay? So now that it's actually been changed, that's pretty much all there is to it. So that's how you change your LM3R's IP address. Or remember, it has to be the same as your router, and you just go through all the steps I just showed you, and that's pretty much how you do that part. Okay guys, well that was pretty much it as far as setting up the network settings on the LM3R. I hope y'all found this information helpful, and please stay tuned for the next part of this video, which I'm going to complete the whole process and get you guys working with your iPad and Luminaire. So thank you all for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and check out our website at series-e.com.